should remember your pastor in prayer. Okay, pastor, no need prayer. Eh? He needs your prayer. 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1 to 7. 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1 to 7. The pastor needs to be prayed for. He said, this is a true saying. If a man desired the office of a bishop, he desired a good work. Verse 2. A bishop then must be blameless, the husband of one wife, vigilant, sober, of good behavior, giving to hospitality, out to teach. Not giving to wine, not a striker, not greedy of filthy looker, but patient, no broiler, no covetous. While the ruler wears his own house, having his children in subjection with all gravity. Verse 5. For if a man know not how to rule his own house, how shall he take care of the church of God? Verse 6. Not a novice, being lifted up with a pride, he fall into the condemnation of the devil. From verse 7 now. Moreover, he must have a good report of them which are without, lest he fall into reproach and the snare of the devil. And the snare of what? Of the devil. So for pastor not to fall into the hand of the devil, he need to be prayed for. The pastor is attacking in the church that the devil is fighting. So, for them not to succeed, he needs your prayers. He needs your prayer. He needs your prayer. As I was teaching in Sunday school, I said, have you ever seen on a social media or television where they say, put a native daughter, don't pregnant again, they're publishing. You don't see native daughter, they say, that they go publish and say, don't give girl belly. Now they see him. But if Pastor Giga Bele, will you see it here? He means anything that or not the Giga Bele, that they do. But nobody talk. But when the pastor do it, the whole world. And today there are a lot of criticism against the pastor. All these are the words of the world or the devil to bring down the pastor. To make the pastor to fall. Somebody say, our pastor will never fall. That is why he needs your prayers. He needs your prayers. And they said, now the tree when it get fruit, neither they throw stone upon. Is that not? This is our guava when they here. Now get some women they chop on. Every time I go see, say they don't go hide for there, they pluck. If the fruit finish, will they go there again? Because they get something. Because the pastor has something to offer. That is why there are a lot of stone. If God open your eyes to see the stone, the devil, especially now in social media, the kind of stone the devil is throwing against the pastor, you need to pray for them. You need to pray for them. It is not their fault. It's not their fault. The devil wanted to fall by all means so that the devil will take their glory. But from today, by the word of the Lord, as we join here together to pray for the pastor, they shall not fall. He needs to be prayed for. And the other one is, you need to pray with him. To pray with him is to gatherness. Just as we organize prayer that day,
If you pray with your pastor, any prayer that he has been scheduled, you will be there. So that you will fight with him. The Bible says one will chase 1,000 and two shall chase how many? 10,000. So you're staying at home when prayer is going on. You are an enemy of the pastor.